Tacrolimus is one of the immunosuppressants. This drug belongs to the category of calcium urine inhibitors. However, what is the effect of this medication on the kidneys? Whether it raises blood pressure? Can it be controlled by antihypertensive agents? Which type of medication should be avoided with tacrolimus? Can calcium channel blockers be used? This video answers all these questions. In this video, we will discuss all such important facts about this medication, tacrolimus. First of all, let us see how does it work. Tacrolimus works by suppressing the immunity, thereby facilitating organ transplantation and reducing organ rejection. One of its main actions is to reduce the signaling of T cells. Within the immune cells, tacrolimus can bind to one of the protein called FKBP12. This is the FK binding protein type 12. Tacrolimus forms a complex with this protein, which inhibits calcium urine phosphate. Normally, calcium urine is required for T lymphocyte signal transduction and IL-2 production. When this calcium urine phosphate is activated, it can stimulate the gene transcription, where the IL-2 gene is going to be activated, resulting in the more release of IL-2. This IL-2 acts as a key mediator for amplification of immune signaling. This IL-2 can bind to IL-2 receptors on the T lymphocytes, thereby proliferating the immune response. Now, tacrolimus can bind to this FKBP protein, thereby inhibiting IL-2 production and T cell activation. Effect on blood pressure. Tacrolimus can cause hypertension. This raised blood pressure can be controlled by use of few antihypertensive agents. However, the potassium-sparing diuretic should be avoided with tacrolimus. Similarly, when calcium channel blockers are used, the dose of tacrolimus should be adjusted. Effect on potassium levels. Tacrolimus can cause hyperkalemia. Therefore, potassium-sparing diuretics like imlaride, triamterene, spironolactone, and eplerenone should be avoided while using tacrolimus. QT prolongation. This medication can increase the QT prolongation in the ECG. This may increase the risk of heart failures and cardiac arrhythmias. This QT prolongation can also be observed with electrolyte disturbances. Few of the conditions like hypokalemia, hypomagnesemia, or hypocalcemia can also induce QT prolongation. Therefore, when you combine tacrolimus with other medications that increase QT prolongation, the risk may be increased. For example, amiodarone is a class 3 antiarrhythmic agent that can increase the QT intervals. Similarly, sotalol can also increase the QT intervals. Class 1 antiarrhythmic agents like quinidine, procainamide, and disopyramide can also increase the risk when they are combined with tacrolimus. Nephrotoxicity. One of the important side effects of tacrolimus is nephrotoxicity. It can produce constriction of renal blood vessels, and it can even produce some toxic effects leading to tubulopathy. This affects the reabsorption and secretion of important components in the tubules. It can also cause tubular interstitial inflammation. Tacrolimus may also lead to development of acute renal impairment. High levels of serum creatinine can be observed along with hyperkalemia, hyperuricemia, and decreased secretion of urea. Most of these effects are reversible, and on discontinuation of tacrolimus, they can be restored. However, this nephrotoxicity can be further increased by use of other medications. Particularly other drugs that produce nephrotoxicity like aminoglycoside antibiotics, antivirals like ganciclovir, antifungals like amphotericin B, anti-cancer agents like cisplatin, protease inhibitors and nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitors may all increase the nephrotoxicity when they are given with tacrolimus. Therefore, while using the tacrolimus, the symptoms of nephrotoxicity should be carefully monitored and the renal function should be assessed. If it is required, the dose of tacrolimus should be adjusted to minimize the nephrotoxicity. Phototoxicity. Tacrolimus can increase the skin sensitivity and it can produce phototoxic reactions. Therefore, direct exposure to the sunlight should be avoided. Particularly, the ultraviolet exposure should be avoided to eliminate phototoxicity. If it is required, sun protection should be used while using tacrolimus. Effect on blood glucose. Tacrolimus can increase the blood glucose, particularly after the transplantation. This condition is called post-transplant diabetes mellitus. Therefore, blood glucose should be frequently monitored after the transplantation. This condition may be further increased when tacrolimus is used along with other immunosuppressants, which can also increase their blood glucose levels. Calcium urine inhibitors include other medications like cyclosporin. It can also increase the glucose levels when it is combined with tacrolimus. Therefore, it should be discontinued 20 hours before starting the tacrolimus. Drug interactions. Tacrolimus is metabolized by CYP3A4 system. Therefore, strong CYP3A4 inhibitors may reduce the metabolism of this medication, which increases its levels, leading to its toxic effects. Particularly, the increase in the QT prolongation can be observed when this is used with strong CYP3A4 inhibitors like clarithromycin. Similarly, CYP3A4 inducers may increase the metabolism of tacrolimus, leading to decreased efficacy. This may result in the failure of immunosuppression and graft rejection. Calcium channel blockers like felodipine, amlodipine, and nifedipine can reduce the metabolism of tacrolimus. They can inhibit the CYP enzyme, which is responsible for the increased levels of tacrolimus, leading to its toxicity. Therefore, in the presence of CCBs, the dose of tacrolimus may be reduced. Tacrolimus has a narrow therapeutic index, therefore any small fluctuations in its levels may produce significant effects on the body. Risk of infections. Tacrolimus is an immunosuppressant that increases the risk of infections. So bacterial, viral, fungal and protozoal infections may be increased. Particularly opportunistic infections can be increased with use of tacrolimus. Since this medication reduces immunity, taking live vaccines may also increase the risk of infections. Therefore, live vaccines should be avoided. Instead, inactivated vaccines can be taken after transplantation. Hypersensitivity. Hypersensitive reactions can be observed with use of tacrolimus. It can produce anaphylaxis. Therefore, after 30 minutes of injection, the symptoms of anaphylaxis can be observed. It may result in skin rashes, difficulty breathing, and swelling of throat and lips. If anaphylaxis is observed, use of IV formulation should be limited. If possible, the IV solution may be replaced with oral administration if it is well tolerated. Now let us see the side effects of this medication. Tacrolimus can produce tremor and hypertension. It can also produce headache, diarrhea, nausea, peripheral edema, constipation, and urinary tract infection. Increase in the creatinine levels can be observed with use of tacrolimus. It can also increase the potassium levels, leading to hyperkalemia. Few other side effects like back pain, dizziness, and insomnia can also be observed with use of tacrolimus. How is it given? Tacrolimus is available as immediate release capsules as well as extended release capsules. These formulations are not equivalent, and even this medication is also available as extended release tablets and oral suspension. The dose depends on the body weight of the patient. It is also variable based on for which purpose it is going to be used. For example, in case of heart transplantation, the immediate release tablets or capsules can be given as 0.075 mg per kilogram per day. This dose can be given as two divided doses. The dose can be administered within 6 hours after transplantation. Medication errors like exchanging between extended release tablets and immediate release tablets may lead to either an increase in the adverse reactions or a decrease in the efficacy, leading to graft rejection. So that's all about the different facts of tacrolimus, how it affects kidneys, and what is its effect on the blood pressure. I hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel and hit the like button. Share this video with your friends and post your comments in the comment box. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.